Holy Week, Palm Sunday, we celebrate God's kingship revealed through the person of Jesus Christ. All of us are living through some very unusual days. I know growing up, my parents reminded me or told me about the Great Depression or World War II. I think if they were still alive, the days of the coronavirus, this worldwide pandemic, would certainly have made their list of some of the most unusual things that certainly they ever saw. Our world is no stranger to plague or disease, but this kind of thing is extremely unusual, touching all the world as it is. And it has changed the way we do business, at least temporarily. Who knows how long it will last. Here at HBU, we are still delivering classes. Our classes are in full swing. We are, of course, delivering them remotely. Our professors are doing that. Our students are in their homes, maintaining social distance. People are also working at home, and the pace of work is going right along here at the university. In fact, we are still recruiting students furiously for the coming fall, hoping that we'll be back in our classrooms, but if not, we'll deliver them remotely. We have a record number of students in the recruitment funnel who are planning and anticipating and applying to come to HBU in the fall. So these are exciting days, strange and unusual days, but let us never forget that God is King over all the earth. That's where we have to start when we think of terrible things like this sweeping across the earth. God is still King over all the earth. Psalm 47 points to the kingship of God, and Palm Sunday reminds us that God's kingship is now revealed through the person that we serve and worship, Jesus Christ, our Lord. In Zechariah 9, it was told Israel that one day Yahweh, your king, will come to you mounted upon the colt of a beast of burden. And Jesus, by prearrangement with his disciples, on that fateful day, 1 week exactly before Easter, just a few days before his gruesome death by Roman crucifixion, he arranged for there to be a donkey, a beast of burden brought to him. He got up on the donkey and he acted out a living parable. And he taught that he was the very fulfillment of that prophecy from Zechariah. The religious leaders, of course, this was not without conflict. They insisted that Jesus should stop his disciples from declaring Hosanna to the Son of David. And Jesus quoted scripture back to them and said that God had ordained through Psalm 8 that even children would bring praise to him. Jesus accepted the praise of those who welcomed him into the city. He said, if these are silent, the very stones will cry out. And so in the midst of a desperate world situation, while there is sickness and disease around us, while we're in these unusual days of trial, God is still King over all the earth, and his kingship has been revealed through the person of Jesus Christ. Let us worship him, because if we don't, the very stones will cry out, he is King.